Who will reign in Spain? It's time to race in MotoGP.
Pecco Bagnaia walked away from the America's leg of the season with two crashes in both MotoGP races. However, the reigning champion returns to a circuit that brought glory and jubilation to Ducati for the past two seasons, where Jack Miller won in 2021 ahead of Bagnaia, with the Italian taking the spoils the following year. A happy hunting ground it may be, but Bagnaia will have in the back of his mind those two costly mistakes. But the silver lining is that he and the GP23 have had searing speed as shown at Portimao and the Tissot Sprint in Cota. And with a circuit like Jerez where he's had past success, Pecco should be feeling confident and ready to put those eras of Argentina and Americas behind him. Marco Bezzecchi's speed has been a surprise to no one, but an 11-point championship lead, not many would have bet on that. However, after three rounds, the Italian leads the standings quite brilliantly. Speed and consistency has been the name of Marco's game, and with the season heating up at Jerez, Bezzecchi is under more scrutiny as his rivals will be waiting for any small mistake. But despite a crash in the Tissot Sprint in Portimao, he has shown he's ready to rise to the challenge and keeping calm under the most intense pressure. 2023's most recent winner enters the Spanish GP full of confidence and ready to repeat the success. However, Rins and Honda's victory could be attributed to the fact that Rins is a connoisseur of Cota, and his smooth throttle delivery and riding style worked hand in glove around the Texas circuit. That being said, the Honda RC213V looks to be an improvement on its predecessor, and in 2022, it just missed out on a podium spot in the hands of Marc Marquez. This weekend will paint a clearer picture whether Honda have made a substantial improvement in 2023 and Rins can be a match on the RC213V. Third place at Cota was exactly the boost that Fabio Quartararo and Yamaha needed to really kickstart their season. Although the speed was there in the race, Fabio found things difficult in the Tissot Sprint, and qualifying still looks to be a weakness. This will be an important weekend for the Hamamatsu factory, as both Yamaha and Quartararo have had success in the past. The 2021 champion taking his first two MotoGP victories at the circuit, and was odds on to win in 2021 until Arm Pump dropped him to 13th at the flag, before coming home a close second in 2022. While Frankie Morbidelli's most recent podium came in the 2021 race, he will be looking to recapture the Argentina form at a circuit he enjoys. Aprilia's season has been somewhat underwhelming in comparison to the speed that RSGP and both riders have shown. Unexpected DNFs and struggles in the wet have attributed to their lowly position in the championship, so a trip back to Europe could be the reset that they need to get their season back on track. Aleix Espargaró showed in 2022 at Jerez that both he and the bike suit the technical Spanish circuit with a podium finish. While Maverick Viñales was on the podium in round 1 at Portimao, with both riders scoring a pair of 4th places in the Tissot Sprint and the race at Cota, all the Noale team needs is a weekend without any issue so they can show their true hand. It's been a season of ups and downs for the factory in orange. With great potential and even a Tissot Sprint win with Binder, some points have gone missing with mistakes. It's clear a step has been made over their 2022 machine, and the speed that both Binder and Miller showed in Cota would have extinguished some of their worries. Both KTM riders will be keen to continue their improved speed, and here will be a great test as Jack Miller will hope to repeat his victory in 2021, and with the recent speed and confidence he showed at Cota in the race, you can't discount him from being in the mix. While Brad Binder, despite where he qualifies, will be in the hunt. Expect those orange machines to flash into view when you least expect, because with Brad Binder and Jack Miller, you can never count them out.
For more MotoGP content, don't forget to like and subscribe. See you at the races.